Welcome everyone and thank you for watching to this podcast. I'm Sir Jackson. Stay blessed as I share the word of God with you people. Today I'm gonna take my text from the book of Kings. I'll start to read from 1 Kings, 2 Kings chapter 1. In fact, I'll start from 1 Kings chapter 22 from the three last verse. Ahaziah, the son of Ahab, began to reign over Israel in Samaria. The 17th year of Jehoshaphat, king of Judah, and reigned 2 years over Israel. And he did evil in the sight of the Lord, and walked in the way of his father, and in the way of his mother, and in the way of Jeroboam, the son of Nabat, who made Israel to sin. For he served Baal and worshipped him, and provoked to anger the Lord God of Israel, according to all that his father has done. Here is another king who reigned over Israel, but caused Israel to sin. As we start to read from the second books of Kings, chapter 1. Then Moab rebelled against Israel after the death of Ahab. And Ahaziah fell down through a lattice in his upper chamber that was in Samaria and was sick. And he sent messengers and said unto them, go inquire of Baal-zebub, the god of Ekron, whether I shall recover this disease. This king is a wicked king. He turned Israel to sin. Now he fell down from his upper chamber to a lattice and was ill. He sent messengers to go and seek not the God of Israel but the God of Ekron, whether he shall recover of this disease or not. He sent messengers to a false god, one of the gods of Ekron. One of the gods of Ekron, he sent messengers to ask whether he shall recover. Watch this. But the angel of the Lord said to Elijah the Tishbite, arise, go up to meet the messengers of the king of Samaria, and say unto them, is it not because there is not a god in Israel that ye go to inquire of Baal-zebub, the god of Ekron? The prophet Elijah, God sent an angel to the prophet Elijah the Tishbite. He said, arise, go up to meet the messenger of the king of Samaria. This king who is going to Ekron to seek the god of Ekron, Baal-zebub. The angel of the Lord appeared to the prophet of God. He said, arise, go up to meet the messenger which the king has sent to Samaria to seek the god of Ekron, and say unto them, is it not because there is not a god in Israel that he go to inquire of Baal-zebub, the god of Ekron? Now therefore, thus saith the Lord, thou shalt not come down from that bed on which thou art gone up, but shalt surely die. And Elijah departed. That is what Elijah said exactly to the servant. Go and tell your master. Now therefore, thus saith the Lord, thou shalt not come down from that bed on which thou art gone up, but thou shalt surely die. And Elijah departed. And when the messengers turned back unto him, he said unto them, why are ye now turned back? That Isaiah the king is asking the messenger, I sent you to Baal-zebub, the god of Ekron, to inquire if I will recover. Why have you come back? without no answer. And they said unto him, there came a man up to meet us, and said unto us, go turn again unto the king that sent you, and say unto him, thus saith the Lord, is it not because there is not a God in Israel that thou sendest to inquire of Beelzebub, the God of Ekron? Therefore thou shalt not come down from that bed on which thou art gone up, but thou shalt surely die. That's the message of Elijah, the prophet, the Tishbite. And he said unto them, what manner of man was he which came up to meet you and told you these words? What manner of man is a prophet? And they answered him, he was an hairy man and girded with a girdle of leather about his loins. And he said, it is Elijah the Tishbite. As soon as the servant described the man, the hairy man girded with a girdle of leather about his loins, he said, this must be Elijah the Tishbite. Then the king sent unto him a captain of 50 with his 50. Afterwards, as soon as the king knows that it was Elijah the Tishbite, he sent a captain of 50 to bring Elijah, to summon Elijah. Say, go and get that man for me. Go and get Elijah the Tishbite for me. And he went up to him. And behold, he sat on the top of an hill. And he spake unto him. The captain went up to Elijah. Elijah was sitting on top of the hill. And he spake unto him, thou man of God, the king had said, come down. And Elijah answered and said to the captain of God, if I be a man of God, then let fire come down from heaven and consume thee and thy 50. And there came fire from heaven and consumed him and his 50. Just imagine, fire came down and consumed the captain and his 50. Oh, Elijah is powerful. Fire came down and consumed the captain and his 50. Again, also he sent unto him another captain of 50. Just imagine, the man of God has called fire from heaven and consumed the first captain and his 50. He only sent another captain. And he answered and said unto him, O man of God, thus had the king said, come down quickly. And Elijah answered and said unto him, if I be a man of God, let fire come down from heaven and consume thee and thy 50. And the fire of God came down from heaven and consumed him and his 50. I command fire from heaven to consume every taxmaster, every captain which are sent by the powers of darkness to defy the word of God for your life. Everyone who is watching this podcast, I release the fire of God to consume that captain and the entourage. And he sent a captain of a third 50 with his 50. And the third captain of 50 went up and came and fell on his knees before Elijah and besought him and said unto him, O man of God, I pray thee, let my life and the life of thee 50, thy servant, be precious in thy sight. Behold, there came fire from heaven and burnt up the two captains and the former 50 with their 50. Therefore, let my life now be precious in thy sight. Oh, this man is very wise. This captain loves his life so much. He takes things easy. He come and fell down on the man of God's feet. He says, spare my life and this 50 men. Don't let fire come down and consume my life and this 50, like the two other ones. Please spare my life. And the angel of the Lord said unto Elijah, go down with him, be not afraid of him. And he rose and went down with him unto the king. And he said unto him, thus saith the Lord, for as much as thou hast sent messengers to inquire of thy people, the God of Israel, is it not because there is no God in Israel to inquire of his word? Therefore thou shalt not come down off that bed on which thou hast gone up, but shalt surely die. Can you imagine that? So he died according to the word of the Lord, which Elijah had spoken. And Jehoram reigned in his stead in the second year of Jehoram, the son of Jehoshaphat, king of Judah, because he had no son. Now the rest of the acts of Isaiah, which he did, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the king of Israel? Yeah, answer Bible reading, our scriptures. Thank you for watching. Let's pray. Merciful Father, thank you because your word is power. You said the entrance of the word of God brings forth life and gives us understanding. You said those that trust in you are like Mount Zion, which cannot be moved. You said those that sow in tears shall reap in joy. He that goeth forth and weepeth, bearing precious seed, shall doubtlessly come again rejoicing, bringing in their sheaves. Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of their God. No weapon that is fashioned against will prosper. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up his standard against him. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I thank you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We give you praise. We worship you. In your presence, that's where we'll be. Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the court of their God. He that goeth forth weepeth, bearing precious seed, shall doubtlessly come again rejoicing, bringing in their sheaves with them. We thank you, Lord. In your presence, that's where we belong. Oh my God. I pray for everyone who is watching. Turn their lives around. Break through from the right, from the left, in every direction in their lives. Deliver them from everything they are going through, every attack of the devil. I command the hand of Satan off their life in the name of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus over their situation in the name of Jesus. I pray for every family member who are not saved. I pray that they will be saved in the name of Jesus. They will be saved in the name of Jesus. In your presence, that's where we belong. Thank you for this time, Lord. In your presence, that's where we belong. I want to be in your presence, Lord. In your presence. We thank you, Lord. Well, stay blessed. I'm C. Jackson. I believe that this word has been a blessing to you. Continue to stay blessed. Please take the time to watch this and be blessed. Amen.